Hello, I'm Bianca from the Netherlands, and they asked me to do this video in English so everyone will know what I saw in hell. It was about 23 years ago, and I didn't know how to call on the name of Jesus. And I didn't believe in hell, and I also didn't believe in the devil. So I was laying on my bed, and also I didn't do any drugs or alcohol. And I was laying on my bed, and my spirit got sucked out of my body. And with a high speed, I came in a tunnel, and the tunnel was going to the deeps, to the depths of the earth. And when the speed was slowing down, the tunnel became smaller and smaller, and everywhere hands came out, and they wanted to grab me and to scratch me. And when the hands disappeared, I came face to face with Satan, and Satan is very big. So I only could see his head. His head was very big, and my body stand still, and I came face to face with Satan. So that big he was, that I only could see his head. And he had red eyes. He had a black skin. But the skin was like of a lizard, and he had teeth like a shark, and it was awful. It was horrific. And at that moment, I knew what eternity was, because. Yeah, you know when you are there, there's no escape. You can escape hell. And I was there, and I was looking at Satan, and then he started to growl, but in a language I don't know. But there came so much hatred. Ooh, the hatred was terrible. And he came after me, and when you are in hell, you can do nothing. You are delivered to the torturers, and they can do everything with you what they want. And so he started to groan and started to talk in his language, but only what I felt was the hatred, and the hatred was it was horrific. It felt like arrows piercing your soul everywhere. You're in so much agony, and I cannot explain it, because it was so awful. It was really horrific. The torture you feeling in hell, and you wanted to scream for help, but I didn't know who I can call to. But I can tell you that the hatred I felt at that moment, it was much worse than we can imagine here on earth. Everything there is million times worse than you have here on earth. When you think, oh, people hate me, put all the hatreds of all the people and put it in one person. And that is what I saw in Satan. And even then, it was million times worse. It was really worse. And I have to warn you, hell is real. Hell is real. And I didn't believe it. But when I was there, all the doubts disappeared. I knew this was Satan. But I didn't know how to call for help. And then a movie came in my mind. I saw a movie that some people were possessed with the demon, with Satan, with the devil, and they called on the name of Michael. I saw it in the movie, so I thought the angel Michael can help me, yeah, because he did in that movie. So I started to cry out, Michael, Michael, save me, save me. And then a cloud appeared. And you know, I didn't know any story of the Bible. I didn't know Jesus will come on the clouds. I didn't know in the Old Testament also God came in a cloud. I didn't know, but I was in hell and I saw a cloud appeared. And I thought that this is weird. What is the cloud doing here in hell? And then the hand came out, and I believe it was the hand of Jesus, but I didn't know at that time. And his hand came out and grabbed me like this, and I painted it. I asked God, please, I want this experience painted. And I painted it, and this was what it was looked like. I was in hell, and I shouted out, and the cloud appeared, and this hand came out, and he grabbed me and put me back in my body. And after that, after this experience, I couldn't really talk for a while. I couldn't get the words out. I didn't dare to tell this story to anyone, because all the people around me are atheists. So it was very difficult. I only told the story of hell to people, but it was many, many years later, many years later. Maybe 10 years later or something, but at the time I couldn't talk to anyone about it. I thought they think I'm crazy, but I was really scared. But after that time I knew hell was real, and I want to warn you. Hell is a real place, and it is really horrific, horrific. You cannot defend yourself. You are delivered up to the torturers, and it's million times worse than you can imagine. You cannot see this horror here on earth, even when people kill each other and do crazy things to each other and do hateful things, even in the war. When you hear of the evil things they did in war, this is million times worse. And you cannot die in hell. You live there forever. So the torture will go on and go on to eternity. So I want to warn you, don't go to that place. Give your life to Jesus today. Don't wait till tomorrow, because you don't know if you live tomorrow. You're one breath away from this place. So please, please. I didn't, at that time, I didn't believe in this. But this is real, and it is horrific. I cannot say it in other words. And even then, when I say horrific, I will tell you, it's much worse than that. So please, please, please give your life to Jesus today. And also I will tell to the Christians, please forgive each other. Please live a truly holy life. Please, please, please. It's not about religion, but it's about a relationship with Jesus. And to obey his voice. Please, please, please. Repent, repent, and give your life to Jesus. He loves you. He gave his life for you. So, God bless you.